हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस कंटिन्यू आर लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर फॉर ए सोसाइटी एंड कॉलोनियलिज्म। नाउ वी टेक द एग्जांपल ऑफ अनदर कंट्री नाउ व्हिच इज इंडोनेशिया। द फॉरेस्ट ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन इन जावा। दिस कंट्री जावा और द जावा आइलैंड इज इन इंडोनेशिया, controlled by or was a colony of Dutch, which means the Holland and the Netherlands. Like Britishers, they wanted timber, the same thing. As I said, in India, Britishers come for raw and market. Similarly, here also the Britishers came for, the Dutch came for these two things. They wanted timber from Java and to build ship. If you see the population of Java in the year 1600, then it was just 3.4 million and there were many villages in the fertile plain also. But the maximum populations were also found that the communities were living in mountains and practicing shifting cultivation. The woodcutters of Java. Kalangs were the communities which is found in Java, which is a skilled community, very famous community, a tribal community which is skilled for cutting woods, and also they were doing shifting cultivation. When these Dutches make Java as their colony in the 18th century, these Dutch tried to make the Kalangs work under them, but this community doesn't accept this thing. Even they do revolt in the year 1700 and attacking the Dutch fort at Jonaha, but as usual this uprising was suppressed by this by the European countries, because they have much latest technology, new weapons and a man in an army in a totally managed manner. The Dutch scientific forestry. As like in India by the Britishers, the Dutchers also enacted forest law in Java, restricting village access to forest. Now wood could only be cut or the areas are specified. Which the villagers can use for cutting, and if the villagers were found, that they are grazing cattle in young stands, transporting wood without their permission, or traveling on forest road with their horse carts or cattle etc., then they were punished by the Dutch government. Here also the Dutch imposed rent on cultivation. They also banned the shifting cultivation, and those who doesn't follow their rules and regulations, they can leave the forest areas, and those who want to stay there, they have to do a free labor also for them, known as a work done without any kind of wages, means bega. Blandin Dienstin. As I said, that the Dutch imposed rent on land being cultivated in the forest and then exempted some village from the rent on land if they work collectively to provide free labor, means the beggar, and also provide them buffaloes for cutting and transporting timbers, which help the Dutchess for their trade. This thing is known as Blundangdisten. It's a Indonesian word. I cannot pronounce it properly, but the spelling is this one. Around 1819, Surontico Simons of Randablatung village, which is a teak forest village, he began questioning the state ownership of the forest. Means the rebel was initiated by Simon. He argued the state that the state had not created the wind, water, earth, wood, etc., so it could not own it. Soon a widespread movement was developed by the Samin. Amongst those who helped organize it were Samin's son-in-laws. Around in the year 1907, 3,000 families were following his ideas. Some of the Samins protested by laying down on their land when the Dutch came to survey the forest areas, while others refused to pay tax or fine or perform labor. So this is how the followers of the Samins show their aggressions and do rebel against the Dutch government. War and deforestation. The First World War and the Second World War had a major impact on forest. In India, working plants were abandoned at this time, obviously. The forest department cut a lot of trees freely to meet the British war's needs, because at that time Britain needs a lot of timber. The same in Java also by the Dutch. We see the Dutch destroy sawmills and burn piles of gang tea so that they would not fall into Japanese hand. For this purpose also they cut a lot of trees. When Japan had a control on Java during the Second World War, Japan exploited the forest recklessly for their own war industries, forcing forest villages to cut down a lot of forest. This is how we see a lot of deforestation during the war period. On the other hand, we also see that the many villagers used this opportunity to expand their cultivation in the forest areas, and after the war it was difficult for the Indonesian Forest Service to get this land back from these villagers. Well, we also see the new development in the forestry. The conservation of forests rather than collecting timber has become more important goal for the Indonesian government. The government has recognized that in order to meet this goal, that is the conservation of forest, the people who live near the forest areas must be involved in it. In many cases across India also, like from Mizoram to South Kerala, dense forest was survived only because village protected them in sacred groves with like known as the Sarnas, Dehara Kudu, Khan, Rai, etc. Some villagers have been patrolling their own forest and with each household taking it turns instead of leaving it to the forest guard. This is what we see in the Indian areas also. Today the local forest communities of India and the environmentalists also, they are thinking a lot for different forms of forest management and forest conservation. So student, this is how we totally completed our chapter Forest Society and Colonizations. Any kind of problem and doubt, you can contact me or you can send your comment also. I am giving my whole detail, that is bipindogra.blogspot.in is my blog where you can visit, or you can directly call me also. My number is 0979970955. That's all in this chapter. Thank you.